this meeting, there will be a presentation about all of the homeownership models and the assistance that comes with it, and they can answer all of those questions effectively.
So
I'm just here to let you know about.
So what he says, and here is as a body that's representing the community of Bakers Homes, I really want to press upon you to consider. He's not here to address the questions, and we get that. Thank you for coming to even share that with us. But on March 2nd, which is next Saturday, if this room is not full, I am going to be truly disappointed, because everybody should come out into the masses to hear not only what happened to the land, but what's being done with it, what's the future progressions on it, and how do I, Miss Jane Doe, homeowner, or aspire to be a homeowner, want to take part of, whether it's the CLT program, whether it's traditional financing, or whatever avenues are out there, give me all of that education at one time, at that particular time. So we'll do the best we can, we'll utilize the connect, and get that information out there to pull people in the masses, because I really want them to hear everything.
And that is exactly why I came out again this month, to say it is important to educate yourselves about the different opportunities. And I'm calling them opportunities because it's not, one may not be for everybody. It's not for everybody, because everybody may not be in the market for a home. But even if you're in the market for a home, you have options with the new home development program. And this is a program that the city of Houston specifically set up to build homes in the neighborhood on these lots that have been tax abated. Otherwise, what had been happening is that, again, these lots were struck off. Let me tell you what happens at the tax auction, just so we're in. What happens at the tax auction is that when a neighborhood becomes an attractive place for development, the tax auction becomes not competitive for places like the land bank. We don't get any of our lots from the tax auction anymore. You know why? Because there are speculators that are coming into the neighborhood and taking the lots and sitting on the lots. The land bank was created to tackle the speculation issue and to actually put the lots back into production. One of the ways that we put it back into production is building affordable housing for the community. Now, the city of Houston has determined that while building affordable housing, that they're going to provide numerous opportunities for people that, again, may not have been able, who might otherwise be long-term renters. They provided multiple options for people to purchase these homes. And that's what you'll find out at the meeting. Long-term vision, again, land bank is repurposing those lots.
Just one more question to say, I'm sorry about this. Just one more question. I just want to make sure this correctly. So the city is funding the building of these homes?
That's correct.
Did they select any builders out of Lakers Home?
No.
How many builders?
I already know that.
I said I'm aware.
For Saturday, be prepared.
Yeah, please be Saturday.
Trust me. Mr. Womack can tell you and some of the other folks, and I've been working with Lakers Home for a long time. I'm very well aware of that. And there's other people that have raised that issue. It will be addressed. It will be addressed in the presentation. Let me just say that. Let me just say that. I'm not new to the area. You guys, you know.
Neither does the mayor.
So I'm very well aware of the challenges, and very well aware of the desires of this community, which is why I've been doing the things that I've been doing for the community for the last 10 years. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.